Hello. Oh boy, what's up everybody? Happy Friday. Yeah, thanks for being here. Granite State Skater, Nyx, Jason, Make, awesome. Appreciate y'all being here. Yeah, the goal of today for me is to get hyped up. I want to go skating in about an hour-ish. And my work has been getting in the way of being able to do my regular Tuesday and Thursday streams. And I'm hearing from them that getting a set schedule is unlikely. So we're going to have to see what that means for the streams. But I figured I might as well just start trying to fit them in where I can. So I have today off. It's beautiful outside. And I was like, you know, I'm going to watch skate videos and eat, drink some coffee anyway. I might as well just get on camera, chat with some friends, see what's going on. So yeah, Austin says he's about to get the Wizards on right now. I came across something that kind of shocked me. Y'all seen these before? What are these? Look at this. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. What are these? 15 millimeter, 11, 15 millimeter, 11 by 15 Wizards. Someone needs to get on this. Make this for concrete. I need to know more about these, man. I was just looking them up, but these are wild. Look at these. I just randomly stumbled across this today. But I didn't know this even existed. They're called Shark Blades. They got a banana rocker to them. Wow. Let me find the website. Is it windy up there? Yeah, it's looking pretty windy. One of our parks is in a really good spot, though. It's just like surrounded by trees and a college campus, so there's a lot of bearings. Yeah, that's like nothing riding on 15 bearings. Hey, all right, yeah, we're all in the same zone then. Cool. Well, let's start looking at some fun skating stuff. I want to quick bring up the Shark Blades by Green Hockey quick, just so we can look at these together. Oh my god, look at this. Iconic. Jamming. Okay, yeah, let's see what they have to say. Alright, the Shark Blades Benefit Calculator. Oh, this is really far over. There we go. Bam. Full screened. Whew. Okay, so, Pro Shark Blades. Oh, this... I didn't even realize these are in a different... This is Swiss made. It's in a different language. Oops. God dang it. How much are these bad boys? I'm seeing $449 CHF. $399 CHF. I don't know what that means. $399 CHF to USD. That's about 440 US dollars. Yeah, that's a Swiss franc. Swiss franc. Whatever you however pronounce that. That is so weird, though. Like, I just... From my understanding, it would stay sharper. Oh, well, this is in English. There we go. Introducing our patented Swiss-made high-precision tool design for synthetic ice... Oh, synthetic ice use. Okay. The development of our own blade, specifically designed to meet unique requirements for our synthetic skating surface, ocean ice, is a core element of our Green Hockey. The key feature of our blades is their sharpness, hence the name Shark Blades. These blades have been tested by Swiss NHL players and easily fit into modern Bauer hockey skates. Now, you can prepare for your winter months and continue training your skills all year round. Our system is the only one in the world that allows you to follow a 12-month professional practice plan. It's an industry game changer that brings you several steps closer to the NHL dream. Bro, look at these. I need to see someone put bearings on these and skate them on concrete, man. There's no way this is wide enough for bearings, but oh my god, that is iconic. Crazy. Okay. spent enough time looking at hockey stuff. Let's look at some actual skate stuff. You got Savison doing Savison things. Freaking skating guitars, man. I want to know where a man gets all this stuff. Does he just like... just like hunt Facebook Marketplace? Skating in water. Desperado. And he makes it look so good, though. Like, he skates guitars better than I can skate... skates. Cody. What's up, my man? Thanks for coming through. Yeah, those poor guitars. Yeah, I would hope that he gets all this stuff secondhand, so at least hopefully it's lived a proper life before my man bashes him on a handrail. What's up, Daniel? Thanks for coming through. We watching some skate stuff, drinking some coffee, getting prepared for a skate session. Gonna be bouncing in about an hour-ish, so I can get a solid 2 hours to skate in before we're gonna go check out a house with the friends of ours. They're getting a house, and they invited us to come along. We're excited to go be a part of that process. Oh, and I checked the wrong one. Impressive. We're trying to get hyped. We're looking at impressive stuff today. Ren Fujiwara. Goodness gracious. I gotta eat this before I procrastinate too much. Eating a protein bar today. So that's how I be. I can't, like... I mean, I know it's noon. I mean, it's noon for me here. But I just, like, I can't eat until lunch. I've been working really hard to, like, force myself to eat just a little bit every day in the morning. I did that today with some cereal. It makes me nauseous eating in the morning, man. Does anybody else have that problem? I hate it. I've really been struggling with that, and so I've been trying to get my way back, you know. I've been trying to get that brekkie. Oh. Top acid out, three top acid. Oh my god. Running so good. That drop. Hold on. I needed more time with this, man. Backy. Drop. Okay, so back, right foot backslide, drop to right foot top porn. Oh my god, that's a serious drop. Like, that is... that is asking for ankle snappage, man. Look at that distance. So freaking low. Yeah, you miss that, and you messing yourself up. May can't eat in the mornings. It's an acid reflux thing for me. Okay. Austin, I can't eat in the morning either. Usually a smoothie a few hours after I wake up, or go straight to lunch. Yep, same. Noon's the earliest I eat too. Dang, we need to find a better regimen for us bladers. I just saw this picture that said there are two wolves inside of you. Both of them want you to eat before you skate. You ever seen that meme? There are two wolves inside of you. One that's a badass and one that snuggles or whatever. That meme, that's one of my favorites. There are two wolves inside of you and both are stupid. Potier with an incredible grab at the Snake Park. Snake Park is, man, that's a bucket lister. How close is Mr. I Rollerboot to this park? I feel like he'd have a good time here. How close is France to Barcelona? Like, we're talking Texas distance too. Like, we're talking about a man. I mean, he drove the Leaf, don't get me wrong, but he understands what it means to travel. I wonder how long it would take a train to get over to there. There are two wolves inside of you and both have diarrhea. Oh, Jason, please. What up, John? Thanks for coming through. Definitely eat before you skate, though. Oh, well, good for you. Yeah, that's what I've really been working on. I've just been... I just get that itch, you know, and I'm just like, just go. I'm packed up. I got my pads on. I'm feeling it right now. It's like, if I don't go now, I'm going to get distracted by something. Bring protein bars with me when I go skating, Cody. Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah, I need to start eating. Like, I've been really good about eating protein after. My body needs something to run on. So I need to get gassed up. Check out these crazy flips on ice skates, man. Wild. Duke Nugent. One of my favorite street skaters right now. Bro's just always taking risks. Look at this drop, dude. No thank you. I wouldn't even do that. Like, I wouldn't even drop. If this were half the height, I still don't think I would even attempt to land a grind, like, drop from platform to grind like that. Wild.
In front of City Hall, hear him celebrate, they having a ball. Highly dehydrated, giant matrix. Live at mind contagious.
Nixie, I get that same ADHD rush where I gotta go now. I feel you. Best I do for myself is a cliff bar on the way to the session. Yeah, that's better than nothing, Nix. I respect that. Yeah, no, I for the first time ever took Adderall the other day because I was like, I have so much cleaning to do. I was so overwhelmed. And I was like, I've been meaning to try ADHD prescription drugs for a long time. Freaking crazy top acid, spacebar top acid. Same with Soul, spacebar Soul over the little kink there. Perfect spacebar too. Feet together the whole time. Oh, I'm sorry, this is just a normal acid spacebar acid. Anyway, yeah, no, I there goes the ADHD, by the way. I took that meds and man, I felt alive. I had energy. I wasn't overwhelmed by all the things I had to get done. I got a lot done. It's like, man, sucks that I am actually pursuing this when I don't have health insurance anymore, because now I need to go to the doctor and get myself prescribed. But, yeah, no, I, it's like, well, I guess it's time to admit that it's just time to go in on getting that diagnosis. Never heard that yet. Tree Tree taught me that. Yeah, when you jump in the middle of a grind, he calls out a space bar, and I love that name, so I roll with that. I feel worthless if I'm not fueled up, gotta hydrate, don't get irate. John, I feel you. Yeah, I'm balancing all my coffee today with a bunch of water. And I actually work at a place called the CBD store that has hydrogen-infused ionized alkaline water dispensers. And it's completely free. We encourage people to come in and, like, fill it up. But that's, like... that's great for hydrating before and after a session. I sweat like crazy, so. Okay. Yeah, fakey 5 mute from, this is, yeah, the Seoul skaters here, right? Crazy. Jun Seong skate? Crazy. I'd be happy if I could ever land a 540 in general. I'm 42 and finally started taking meds. It's worth it. John, thank you for saying that. I appreciate that. Yeah, I reached out to Rob Dark, actually, after I took it. And I was like, hey, man, you were the one that told me to pursue... To pursue ADHD meds after I talked a little bit more about just, like, things that I've dealt with my whole life. And yeah, my depression was at an all-time low. My anxiety was super suppressed. I wasn't overthinking, and I've had so much energy, and I've struggled so much with not having energy. So yeah, it's time to start pushing for that, and I can't wait to see what my skating turns into after I get a diagnosis and prescription. I need to find a fat bar near me. Fat bar is, like, so fun. I know I'm gonna struggle with them for a while, but... I just gotta get myself, like, a 4-inch, 6-inch PVC pipe. It's skating is the best cure for depression. Yeah, absolutely, Cody. And I, ever since picking up skating in 2022, my depression has been subverted substantially. My relationships have evolved. This is what I really caught my attention. It's the frickin' Christ Torque Cess slide. Does he do it? Am I mistaken, or does he do it both ways? Maybe I'm mistaken. But the frickin' drop to soul, super cool. Maybe I'm thinking of a different person, different video. Good stuff, though. From Scully Main. I swear I'm following this person. Just, Instagram on PC ain't great. Hey, oh yeah, dude, the Kinked Fat Bar. So that park is, what's the story with that? Have they torn it down yet? Yeah, I gotta get back out there, dude. I do want to skate those parks with you now that I'm feeling better. Definitely getting to a good spot. This has got to be one of the cleanest... Oops, what did I just do? You did something in OBS. This has got to be one of the cleanest, like, slappy switch-ups I've ever seen. Oh my god. Right foot sweaty to true right foot sweaty. True kind grind, I guess. But... goodness. Hey, what's up, Sean? Yeah, I'm trying to get myself hyped for the skate session here in another hour. Yeah, I it's beautiful weather, it's kind of windy, so I know I need to be in a good mood to be able to just be like, you know what, the wind's pushing me around, but we're still having a good time. You feel me? Now let me lock that down. Hold on, I'm trying to situate some things in OBS quick. We'll just let this beautiful clip play. Is it this one? Yeah. It's so, I just dislike, Instagram on the PC so much. Because, like, when I go full screen, you've got this whole black bar over here. But then when I go back, like, the screen is all the way to the left. And you just, like, I don't want all this... Like, I wish you could just close this text in the side, you know? And when I go full screen, yeah, it puts it off. Ugh. Let me arrange this, I guess, since... There we go, that's a little more centered. Move it this way. Yeah. Being really picky, I'm sorry guys. It's this coffee. It's got me feeling all kinds of ways. Okay, now we go back and it's too far over, but what if I do this? Yeah, it doesn't matter. God, that's annoying. Yeah, I just don't have a good way to do it, you know? We're just going full screen for everyone. D-Murds. I thought this was cool. Dominic Bruce style thinking here, I feel. Sporadic foot movement. Love it. Hey, DM your new skate park plan. Sick. Thanks, brother.
Val Kilmer.
Ah, okay. Thanks, Sean. That's actually generated by, just like, text or GIF keyboard or something like that. You can enter any text and it will animate it in a bunch of different ways for you. So it's like, I'm taking that. Hey, thanks, homie. This little bit is so cool. Tree bonked a little, Yeah, that's 180 to a backpacky. Because he's looking right at it when he does that. Wild. That's so cool. Let me pull up this, this goodness.
Instagram!
Sick. It's like a fun little street session. Hello? Why isn't Instagram doing anything? It's just doing nothing. Oh, okay. Okay, here we go. Now it's working. Man, I know that Meta is just kind of, not my man Meta, the Facebook company. I know they just kind of like, they just coasting. They ain't doing anything good. But can you guys try anything with Instagram, please? Like, Instagram on PC is horrendous. Alright, we're looking at, Jason Coverstone's park here that's gonna be built this summer. Had a chance to skate with Jason a few months ago, very loosely because I was pretty fresh off my injuries back onto the skates. But this is exciting. My hunger skate parks too. Check that out, dude. You're getting a snake run. I'm gonna be there. This is interesting concept. It's like a spoon. Morning stream, what's good? Yeah, it might be. I thought the same thing. It's not centered, that's annoying. Hold on, I need to fix that. Eh. Gotta move my screen. Please. Can I click on? Goodness gracious. There we go. OBS sometimes, man. Alright. That's better. Okay, now we're good. Sorry about that. This is how I be. Ooh, look at this rainbow ledge. That looks fun. This looks like a fun bank to gap too. Bowl looks incredible, yeah, to say the least, man. It's a little phallic. Yeah, unfinished business. Who can name what video this was in? We just watched it. It was a BG, right? I'm pretty sure most of the songs that are in here that are like you'd think are copyright but aren't are from sections we've watched that didn't get the stream taken down, so I'm trying to add section music. I think it's fun, but for exactly that reason, people are like, oh shit, I remember this. Oh, look at this rendering. Okay, they getting fancy. Look at that. They got the sun with some light flares. This does look fun. Could you imagine finding a skate park that just is like surrounded by miles and miles of flatland? That honestly would be so surreal. It's like skating in Minecraft. Yeah, ooh, pool coping, I didn't notice that. Yeah! Wonder if this is gonna be oververt or if that's just gonna be a little bit of just tall. It looks fun, man, like my only concern when I look at it from here is, yeah, you've got sections, but I wonder how many people are going to be trying to take it, like, from others, if you get what I mean. Like, there's, you can section it up to a bunch of different things, but I do wonder how many people are going to come from, like, here, blast that way, and try to hit all these things and interrupt people that are sessioning individual parts. That's always been my biggest thing with slim parks, is I feel like I bump into people a lot, or I'm constantly having to be like, hey, you're, I was literally just about to hit that, and you came in out of nowhere and basically took it from me, ran into me. Snake Park should be pretty good, just for being able to follow each other around. But yeah, we'll see what that dynamic is like. Looks pretty big, so it's exciting though. New parks always fun. New concrete in general always makes everything feel good. That's exciting, dude. I guess it just stays zoomed out, and then it centers it better. There we go. I figured it out. Kelso and opinions. Rumpet. Hey. Awesome, thanks for coming through. Gonna hit the wizards, wishing they were shark blades. Someone will 3D print some shark blades for us. Gotta come up with a different name, though. I think shark blades, piranha blades. Call them piranha teeth. Can, call them razor wire. See if Razor gets upset. John, the Jack's Art Park in downtown, it's about to open. It's under a bridge. Jack's Art Skate Park. Jack's, you saying, like, the Jacksonville? Pump track will come later. Okay, I'm excited for that. I've never ridden a pump track, and I've always wanted to. Goodness. Sean is so good. More aggressive ice skating. I really think this would be super fun to try. Woohoo! Kong flip on the ice! Goodness. This is probably synthetic ice, right? Daniel, my town built a new pump track as a part of a new park. The pump track's been sitting here since 2002 and no one can skate it because the park isn't open yet. Oh, what?! Bro, let's break in. Hey, what's up, Kate? Hey, old mayor. Appreciate you coming through. We're just getting hyped up. In about 40 minutes, I'm gonna skedaddle to go do some skating because it is beautiful out and it's my day off. And I figured I might as well do a little stream since work is, I got a new job and my schedule is not, set anymore. I used to work 8 to 4. Monday through Friday, and now I can work potentially every single day from 9 to 9 any day, so. And I've been told that a set schedule is not possible right now, so. That's really the biggest letdown of the position, otherwise it's been a great job, but. Yeah, I gotta try to figure out what that means for the streams. They might just be random like this, so you know, ring that bell. Ring that bell. Ah. Bring up my ring lights closer now that you can't see them. Yeah, look. Here's the ring lights. But when I'm in a little computer mode, you can't see them. Jimmy Sizz here with the crazy sizzle with the Sizz slides. This isn't a Sizz slide, by the way. He has actually invented a trick called the Sizz slide, where it's like a Flamingo Royale Sizz slide or whatever. If I'm remembering correctly. He's done a few NBDs. But yeah, my man just casually... Seth sliding, Seth slide 360. Ooh, you gonna dig this. Into a frickin' top torque sole. Oh, and he changes. I didn't even notice. Oh, wait. Was that just wrong? Did I just completely see that wrong? No, it was just top horn. What's wrong with me? How did I even get torque sole out of that? What did I see? But yeah. Goodness gracious, Jimmy is just so frickin' good. Oh man, miss you, Jimmy. Want to skate with you again? Hey, beat four wheels. Hey, yeah, nice shirt. Thank you. Shout out to supporter of the stream, feet and four wheels, Shawn Michelson. Thank you for the shirt, homie. I was supposed to give this to Joe Atkinson at Winter Clash, but man was a mystical unicorn, and I could not find him anywhere. So this is now the Joe Atkinson remembering shirt. Never forget the day I couldn't find Joe Atkinson. I saw a bunch of clips of him too, and I was like, dang, I guess I wasn't looking hard enough, man. Just watching Sizz, looking at old Crowder Power clips, getting excited for tomorrow. He won it in the first year. Yeah, dude. Y'all have fun tomorrow. I wish I could make it out, but I gotta work. Yeah, just, you know, losing a job never comes at a good time, but I was like, in the middle of planning my Crowder Power trip when I lost my job. I was like, well, dang. I'll try to hit the next one. We're old, man. Hey, Rob, what's good? Thanks for coming through. We're watching some skate clips, getting hyped for skate session today. I'm gonna go skate here in about 45 minutes. Nils is just, he's so good. Some Kudo clips, always fun to see. Man's just doing street. Watch this, street zero backflip. He's so good. It is so good. You needed to play some Sandstorm to summon him, apparently. Yeah, man, I guess so. That was probably my favorite blading moment of all time, honestly. Like, a comp memory. Just all of a sudden, Sandstorm starts playing. That's already epic. Everybody's already jamming, just like, oh, shit, we going down. And then Joe Atkinson here to do his final trick after freaking shaking the ground with his ribs hitting that rail. I still swear to God, I could feel him. Like, I could hear it for sure. I swear I could feel the impact of him across the park hitting that rail. And then he comes back and does that trick. Got my man Tay. It's not my job, man. He, with a huge Machio. Man's got hops. Good job, Tay. Sick shirt, too. Love that shirt. Tay is so cool. I want to be Tay when I grow up. This is... I think this was... Oh, yeah, it was slowing down. You can tell from there and then his movement from his arm. But I was like, this grind just took a deceptively long time in that first clip. But look at this. How many of you would skate this? I don't think I could convince myself to skate it. First, because it's on the left side, so I'd have to top sole it. That's the only topside trick I could maybe get. And even then, I don't think I would make it connect. I don't think I'd be able to hold on to it. But it looks fun, man. It looks real fun. So good. Tree doing tree things, skating in the fetal position. What? Austin Paz asked, what's this called? Oliver St. John Muliscaro. Man, what a name. Cess Press Stress Depress. Beautiful. Yeah, Tree's still out the compound living it up. Oh my god. Guys, look at this and tell me your knees don't hurt. What in the name of God? That is face at the end. Oh. God, this is so good. This is just... I swear I could watch that all day. That is so good. Oh my god. Bro, what the hell? Oh, did he get fractal skates? Sick. Yeah, I'm excited for him, dude. Yeah, that's gonna be cool. Yeah, seriously, the way he pops out of this, too. Like, it's one thing to hold this. It's another thing for my man just to be like, I'm gonna stand up, like, using the side of my knees. Look at how he stands up here. You can see his leg bend, like, inward. My man's knees made of kryptonite, dude. What the heck? Or Jimmy Sizz with the friggin', oh my god, what do you call this? Open book, right? Open book grind? Jimmy. Took all the stees. Wild. Yeah, open book. Crazy. Frickin' Pencil Royale, not even a cab driver. I feel like Pencil Royale would be harder than a cab driver. Can't do either, so I don't know, but... Spread Eagle. Call it the Thigh Wide. Nils is so calculated, so clean. Ugh. Feet together Royale. I can't even begin to understand what it takes to know that. Oh, Pencil Favre, is that what it was? Cab drivers are fun. I can't do them. Can't do them. Maybe I should practice that today. Cabber. Dude, look at this rail. What in the name of God? Hold on, let's rewind this. Bro, frickin' kind grinds up the key hump of this frickin' rail. Look at this. What in the name of God? Zero kind grind on the worst looking rail I've ever seen in my life. Like, don't get me wrong, Schmitty's Dragon Rail, the friggin' Brontosaurus, the Dragon Rail Rex, that thing was crazy, but this, honestly, I feel like has the same amount of intimidation factor, and it's like a quarter the size. I can't even be- yeah, what the fuck is that rail? That's what I'm saying, bro. What in the name of God? And then a frickin' Dark Side Topsoil, is that what that was? It does a little bonk, too, is that what I'm seeing here? Yeah, a little backy bonk. The frickin' Topsoil on the far side of the box. And then into a Topsoil on the rail that's in the middle of the box. And that's a wide box, too. Ren Fujiwara. Prime example. Of some of the best skating. Oh my god, this is just too much in one clip, man. He should have dropped these all as individual clips. This is just way too much to process at once. We're just gonna let this one run through a few times. Like, if you haven't watched this clip from Ren, study it, please, because you'll. It's very pleasant. It's not just incredible; it's mesmerizing the way he does it. Far Side Soul. Ah, okay, that makes sense. Ugh. And then up the down part of the rail, transfer, massive transfer too. Like, this isn't a small transfer. Makes it look easy, but that's right here's gotta be 2.5, 3 feet. And then it's got another foot, so it's about 4 feet total, I would think, about to the left. And then it's up a good, probably same distance, like 3.5-4 feet, and takes the distance that way. So my man is over 4 feet, up 4 feet, down 4 feet. Look at that. He lands on it, like, at the end of the box. I mean, that's probably 3 feet, maybe 2.5, but still. You get what I'm saying. It's impressive. It's beat, where's it from? What were we listening to? Let's see. Oh, this is Controller 7. Here, I'll share the link in Spotify for you. I don't know if you got Spotify, but at least you can get the artist and the name on there. Controller 7, unknown. Yeah, if you're ever hearing some instrumentals now too, there's a good chance it's Moonman Music. I added all like 40 of Phil's songs to the playlist, so we've got some randoms, and then we got some Blatermade music. V importante. Right foot toe roll down this frickin', I'm sure, slippery granite block gap to the street. Like, going fast too. What's up, Matt? Thanks for coming through. Crazy. Jeff Dalness. Grinding a handrail, jumping out and gapping over handrail. Was that glass? Was that freaking glass? Did I just see that? Bro, you're a psycho. You have absolutely no fear for your well-being. What in the name of God? Who wants to grind a dumpster full of glass, y'all? You want to go out and do some street skating? I know this perfect spot. A dumpster full of shards of glass. It's perfect. What a badass. Oh my god. Yeah, Dalness is a beast. Left-handed Straw, incredible album. Definitely check it out. Yeah, for sure. I've listened to it once through. I need to spend more time with it. But yeah, I just sat down and listened to Controller 7 for a while. Baby rail looks awesome. Yeah, dude, I just want some metal baby rails, like short. I want all heights of rail. Look at this. What a disgusting rail. Who made that? That is so weird. God. Jeff. He spins, bro. Moon Man, Love Heart, that's what we're listening to right now. F a gator pit, give me a glass filled dumpster. Sean, you right. Why set something on fire when you could set your skin on fire with all the venereal diseases you'll attract from an open dumpster of shards of glass? Oh my god. Hey, hey. Gabriel Rivera. On the movement team, if y'all didn't catch the stream of Phil Gripper, Phil and some homies are starting up a six-man crew. Just a bunch of dudes. A bunch of people. I'm sure they're gonna expand all sorts of people. But as of where we stay, they got six guys on there right now that all love blading very, very much. And their goal is just to work on projects together as a bunch of dudes who are just motivated to do it. They're not looking for money. They're not looking for recognition. They're looking to have a good time together. My man couldn't help himself from grinding the roller rink. Love it. I do, actually, let me quick go back. I think this is the clip where, it's probably his favorite clip, because the other ones I remember were all, like, attempts. But my man running upstairs. Tiny little soul guy in there. Fantastic. MBMNT. Movement. Wu-Tang-ish. Glass will bite you whether it's hungry or not. No discrimination. More Sizz, because, you know, I'm always impressed by what Sizz is doing. Look at this. Jimmy is not short either. I'm pretty sure he's taller than me. What is he, 6'1", 6'2"? This is 4.5 feet, probably. Maybe 5. Ugh. The freaking AOTP. Wait, AO Topsoil. My bad. Look at the angle. Look at the angle of his legs. Hold on. Let's get that zoom in there. Look at this. Oh my god. Ugh, Jimmy. He's so good. Sausage Sims, one of the other movement skaters. Super exciting. Trying to remember what it is that he gets in this, but it was wild. There it is. Oh. Yeah, and then there is a somersault to double positive. Double fish, I guess. Wild, absolutely wild. Where was that? We gotta go back. Oh my god, he's so, that's so fun. MBD? Anybody ever done this? Somersault to double fish? Double Machio? Railroad Grind? Alright, there you go. That's a good one. I like that name. Freaking Somersault to Railroad. Not only that, but can we talk about the friggin', I don't know, it's just a 180 to X grind. Which way is he spinning? He's coming from the left, I guess, and he spins inward. So AOX, step over to another X, different X. Or is this X-Wing, technically? It's X-Wing, right? Can you do it like that? Positive hot dog, a corn dog. Railroad. Yeah, railroad's good, but I do like corn dog too. That's fun. Oh, this was sick, dude. Look at this. Perfect spin and connection right down into the coping. And you can even see, watch at the very end there, goes into a little cess slide, perfectly swivels out. X-Wing, yeah, sick. Alright, thanks, Cody. Wild. Woo! Negative fishy on the box. That does not look like a forgiving box either. And the park is wet. Crazy. Oh! In spin negative fish. I really need to learn Pawn Star Step Back Soul. I gotta practice that today. That'd be a fun one. Hold on, what was that one? Negative top acid. Ugh, that looks painful. Oh my god. Chaw, this is Moon Man. Last one, I think, was Moon Man 2. Yep, all four seasons is the last one we were listening to by Moon Man. The one we're listening to right now is Victory by Moon Man. New one? Dig it? Oh yeah, brother. Is this the one you're talking about? It's just negative top acid. I just can't even begin to wrap my head around that bending. Hops on Duke. Yeah, like I said earlier, but he really is one of my favorite street skaters right now. He's got it all. The switch-ups, the hops, the precision, the style. Really been loving the What's Brewing videos. Reminds me of Blockhead. No shit. The one playing now. Yeah, no, this is Victory by Moon Man. Yep, this is Phil Gripper. Yeah, shout out to Phil. Man's a legend. Supports the scene in as many ways as he can, but on top of that, makes his dope music. Then check this out, my man, Takeshi. Oh my god. Like, how tall is that ramp? It's gotta be like 12 feet, right? 10? It's probably 10. Maybe 12. It's between 10 and 12. We'll go with that. My man, like, gaps off. God, yeah, how tall is this even? This has got to be 10 feet. This could be even more than that. That could be like 15. That's got to be like 15 feet. Yeah, because this has got to be like 10. Look at him compared to the size of this ramp when he's coming up. Okay, yeah, so if he's 6 feet, this is probably 10. This has got to be like 15 feet. My man jumps from the 10. AO souls vertically down the 15 foot. Beautiful soul. So good. Yeah, freestyle over some movement for sure. Yeah, he threw down some freestyle at the very end of the stream too. Meta brings up his little rubber band instrument and Phil raps over it. I've never heard someone freestyle over a rubber band. That was an NBD for me. Here's Air DeMont. Air Damon. I call him Air DeMont. So that's how I pronounced when I first found his channel or his Instagram. Air DeMont. But yeah, Air Damon. Gapping a Corvette. Golden hour too, the sun's setting, it just makes the footage look so beautiful. Yeah, Phil rocks, man. Oh yeah, Matt, corn dog over hot dogs for sure, for sure. Hot dogs for me, like, unless they're grilled and like small, I don't like brats, I don't like sausages, I don't like jumbo hot dogs, but I like some like grilled hot dogs. But even then, I would take a corn dog over any form of hot dog, honestly. I'm just not a huge fan of hot dogs. CJ catches his hat on his back, grabs it. This crazy twist and spin, and then it lands on his back. That is actually epic. Look, it come off his head. Donk! Sean, my buddy I play with all the time back in the day, has been doing a lot of filming for Damon. Oh, sick. Yeah, that's awesome, dude. Super cool. He's got to be fun to film with. Such a crazy explosive skater. Julio still putting out absolute banger tricks on the A-frame rail. Back torque up. Grabbed back torque. Kind of bad. Kind of grabbed. You know, a little slappy grab. It's a little touchy torque. He kind of like windmills his arm like he's throwing his foot up. That actually looks pretty cool. Whoop, get that up there. Yeah, to step over T-Peasy. Beautiful trick sequence. Looks so good. It's an interesting little box. I probably set slides pretty well. Outspin fishy. Grabbed. Crazy. Firecracker on the thick cement, boy. My man Chris with the zero fish on this fat firecracker. Goodness gracious. Danilo with this crazy little flip. Look at this. Look how short and steep this quarter is. And my man pulled a freaking... What is this? A five cork? I don't know. What is that called? Ugh. The new DL shadows. Matt, you ever tried shadows before? I liked my shadows, but they're definitely bulky. And I just felt like I couldn't dial them in as well as I could dial in a hard shell skate. So I'm really liking the Mesmers. I feel like I can get them to feel the same every time I skate them. Whereas with the shadows, I just feel like I remember my foot always felt like it was in a different position. My skate always felt, you know, I had to like skate and then keep tightening and tightening as I was skating to the point, like until I got to a comfortable point. For me, it was hard to get the skate perfectly tight fitting without, you know, like getting some movement in it so that you're settled into the right place, because there's so many variables. I found myself settling in different parts of the skate, if that makes sense, where I'm either further back or further forward than I usually am. And it's just because there's so many moving parts on that skate. But they skate really well. Soul Plate is really fun. I love the DL shoes too. I'm really hoping that they end up going on sale and I can grab some for a cheap price, just like the shoes themselves, because I know they sell them. I accidentally clicked out of this, but my man Oigan on the Epics. I gotta get me some Epic shoes too, man. They just look so fun. I feel like it's easy to gloss over this. That too. The fact that he's dragging rubber and he's still going. Like, look at this. His toe and his heel are definitely touching at points there. But grinding this in soap shoes? It has to be said, my man's H-block game is top, absolute tippy-toppity. Woo, that was cool. I didn't catch this part at the end. Just a front side to like a natural fast slide. He just lets the little bit of lift at that curve gets him, push him right up into that fast slide. So sick. Good stuff, Wigan. I want to talk about this spin again. So cool. It looks like he brings his legs around in perfect timing. It's those tricks that like halfway through pull out an extra spin. That looks like they pull out the extra spin, like you're almost expecting it to end and then boom. They got a little quick movement. Those are my favorite. Ugh, I'm burping. Excuse me. Matt, I have not just interested in them, but now I'm second guessing that choice after your experience. Yeah, I hate to sway away from them because, you know, like, here's the thing. You know you like your shred pools. And for me, a soft shell boot kind of has that same feeling too, just not as dramatic. I felt with the factions, I didn't have that because they fit perfectly. So if yours fit perfectly, then that's a different story. But if they're a little big, a soft shell that's just a little big is going to be probably like... I use percentages a lot and they usually don't make sense, but I would say it's like 50% comparable to a shadow, just as far as how, like, wiggle room and how the skate flexes. You get a lot of flex in the shadow just because there's so much less stuff binding you to the platform. And I washed out on my soul plates a lot. What I mean by that is when the frame is on, and you go to, like, skate, essentially, you know, you're just looking for that power transfer. I found myself hitting the soul plate a lot. You know, like, if you're going to go forward and you put your foot sideways to try to, like, step sideways and push off, I would just, like, I'd find my wheels sliding out and I'd be sliding on my soul plate. Had that a lot with the shadows. It took a long time to learn how to get right on top of those. Even with the wish frames, I still struggled with just the flex. They do flex a lot. But if you're looking to get some new grinds, those are definitely the ones that I would suggest for learning new stuff. Just be very confident in your knees and your ankles, because, those don't have great ankle support. So much so that Tree and I actually snapped our skates in the exact same spot. Here, I'll go grab them. Doing a fish brain. I don't know what Tree was doing. Well, I could look it up because I got it on camera. But Tree broke his shadows in the exact same spot as me. And that is right here. Now, don't get me wrong. These are older. The new ones, I haven't seen crack like this. But you just got to know that all of your bendiness is right here, you know? Like, when it bends, it's gonna bend over that point. You see that? So, yeah, again, I don't want to be the guy to talk you out of shadows, but just so you know what you're getting into, they're a unique skate for a unique type of skating. And I mean, that's why Tree Tree and Tay use them. Look at how they skate. But yeah. If you're looking for that freedom of feet feeling without having to buy from a company that's dead, like REMS. I'm sorry, that was rude. but the shadows will do a good job for you. Very bottom of the cup, yep. It's the weakest spot on the 1.0 cuff. Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah, all of that bendiness goes right into that little sliver that connects to the sole plate, and it's not ideal. Alright, y'all, I'm gonna quick scroll through the YouTube. Let's find a good hype skate video to finish off with. And then I'm gonna get moving. Hey, alright, here we go. Barcelona file, perfect. Let's watch some Barcelona skating. Barcelona, Barcelona. Appreciate you. Oh, what Sean got? Rory. Let's watch this quick. Oh yeah. Yeah, this one's crazy. Insanity. I've never seen a hippie jump. Hey, there's a F4W shirt. Never seen a hippie jump on skates. Beautiful. Yeah, I've seen it. Old shadow stuff. Oh yeah, but it's worth the review. It's worth to watch. What a weird rail that is. Double grab abstract 360. Very nice. I love the finger flips on the shadows. Epic. Oh, it's still playing. All right, Switch. I love that. 24 frames per second. We getting some real action here. Great shot. Fantastic shot. Nailed the focus on that switch up there in the B-roll. That was beautiful. Woo! Look how crisp that shot is. Oh my god. Nice transition too. Matt, meant to ask, we have basically the same Mondo. How does your 910 Mesmer's fit stock? Fantastic. I'd still say the 909 medium with the 44 second skin fit still is the most perfect fitting skate for me, but the Mesmer is right behind that. The Mesmer has just probably a millimeter or two less than I need. I put my super feet insoles in there, and then they were a little too tight. Without the insoles, absolutely perfect. With the insoles, which I absolutely need because my arches need the support, I'm squeezing into them just a little. So I feel foot fatigue in the first like 30 minutes, 45 minutes. Like after about 30 minutes, it develops. It's there for like 15, 20 minutes, and then it fades away. The 909s, I never had any issues ever. Always amazing. The Mesmers, I've only had that little bit of issue after customizing. But no, I've got a 270, if I remember correctly, a 275 right foot, a 273. Left foot or something like that. I always switch up the two, but one of the foots is a little bit bigger than the other, and the Mesmers fit fantastically. So, which is ironic because a lot of people said that the M12s and the Mesmers were similar, like in how they fit for slim feet, but the M12s have been some of the most painful skates I've ever skated, and the new Mesmers feel amazing. Not to mention, I guess, the John Bellino Mesmers also were probably one of the most painful skates I've ever skated, but the TS1 is one of the best skates I've ever skated. Oh, that and, just obligatory, I gotta say this. I'm gonna run this back because I wasn't watching it at all. If you're getting the Mesmer, get buckles. Doubles! Love to see doubles. Get new buckles. Do yourself a favor and get Jad straps. I love the Jad straps on the Mesmers, dude. It is the perfect amount of flex with that high cuff, but then the flex from the Jad straps from the natural leather. Oh, it's so good. But yeah, those buckles will break on you. Hey, that's great, because I'm a 272. Perfect. Yeah, no, for me, I have the 43-44s. I have the 42-43s. Fuck, what do I have? 41-42s? I can't ever remember these numbers. The numbers, Mason, what do they mean? The numbers, Mason. I'm gonna let this run and then we'll get back to talking. This rail looks super fun. That's why they did the doubles at the end there. Oh, the same rail. Man, they sessioned the crap out of that rail. I love that. They did a good job using the angles, too, to make it look like different spots. If you aren't really paying attention, you might not have noticed. That's pretty cool. God. Front backslide, three out. Ooh, negative wheelbarrow. Okay. Sick. Yeah, but if you're a 272, I would get the size 910s like I did and put an insole in there. Top peasy. On the square. Sick. Ayo, top soul. It's a stair bash. Very nice. Ugh, those corner grinds, dude. Back Roy around the corner. Step around to back salve. Oh, and then back to the freaking topsoil again. I have so many tricks I have to practice. It's a cool angle. I do wish they would have played it all the way through, though. Woo! Topsoil gap up to topsoil. Fat rail up to a angled ledge. It's pretty cool. What's up, ZC? Thanks for coming through. We're actually going to be ending it soon because I got to get out and go skating. It's 12:50 here, and I got things to do around 4, so I want to get a solid 2 hours in. Get there about 1:30, skate two and a half hours. Call it good. Soul, right foot soul, switch up to left foot topsoil at the very end. Why did it pause? What's going on here? It's still running, but it paused. YouTube. It did it again. What's happening? Huh. It, what? What the heck? I've never seen that before. There's just a small section that can't even, it won't load. And now it does. Okay, so I can like step it back a little bit, but huh. Hold on, I gotta refresh, see if that fixes anything. Alright, let's see. Hey, alright. Right foot sole, switch up at the very last second to the left foot top sole. Right? Goodness. And then the double backs. Double back royales. Very nice. It's a sign to go out and skate. You're absolutely correct. Absolutely correct. Yeah, if y'all got the chance to go and skate today, here is your call to action. Please go skate. I'm asking you to. I'm asking you. Go show all the locals how cool it is to be a blader. I've been playing aggressive inline sections at work because I get to pick what goes on the TVs because it's just one person per store, which has been a crazy vibe. I've never just run a store by myself other than this fudge shop I worked at where we had like 4 hour shifts, but you still got checked on a lot by the owner and stuff. Anyway, this the place that I'm at now, I was playing, I want to say it was Denial. I think Denial was on screen, and two boarders come in, and they come to pick up their stuff, and as the other one finishes transaction, he turns around and starts watching the TV, and his friend starts, I start ringing up his transaction, and he taps him on the shoulder, and he points to the TV, he's like, dude, it's like, I swear rollerblading's harder than skateboarding, do you think it is? And he's like, look at this, and they're both watching these dudes skate handrails. I should have taken note of like who it was at the moment because I want to say it was an actual section. Like it was someone's dedicated section in Denial. Anyway, you know, they're just doing crazy handrail stuff like everybody in Denial. And they were shaking their heads and just like, I don't get how anybody can do stuff like that. I was like, man, I feel that way about skateboarding. Don't get me wrong, I feel this way about blading too, but I also feel that way about skateboarding. It's like, it's just this level of skating, whether you're on a scooter, a board, a BMX, when you're doing something on handrails, that's crazy. You're good. Like, you're good at your sport, and that's always fun to watch. and they agreed, and they, I told them to get some skates, so hopefully I'll see some homies on skates soon, but, we got another, I got my homie Chef, Chef Stance on Mesmers, super excited, he got the Dom Bruces, and they actually fit, they feel good, so my man's got new skates from this era, he's not skating skates that are 15 years old, and they don't make him feel like crap, they make his feet, feel free. So super, super excited about that for my homie. And then we got another brother hooked up. One of my friends, Aiden, he switches between boarding and blading, but he's been really getting into blading recently. He loves John Bellino. And so he ordered some Mesmers. So we got a small Mesmer crew in West Michigan now. I mean, I'll be skating by Mesmers for a while. I'll be grabbing standards at some point just because I have to try them. But Mesmers would probably be my go-to for a little while now, like the 909s were for 10 months. I'll probably skate the Mesmers for a good while, especially since I'm not making as much money. I won't be buying skates left and right unless someone wants to send me y'all. Echo, I'm looking at you. And Flying Eagle. Flying Eagle, I don't know. Flying Eagle, I reached out to them on email and on Instagram. They didn't reply to either of them, but both their accounts followed me. I was like, hopefully that means maybe there's like the wheels are turning in corporate, because I know that it's not just like one dude that makes the decision. But it's like, hey, I'll take, please, I'll take some. I'm trying to get hooked up with Echo Skates and Flying Eagle Skates. Batting in the, Aero Roller Works in Mexico. I want to get some of their skates too. But Sean said himself, open mouths get fed, you know? So that's what I'm working on. What? Dare to tell me you've shown him the Bladen Aiden Garbage Pail Kids card? Bladen Aiden? What is that? Bladen Aiden? I know what Garbage Pail Kids are, but I didn't know there was a Bladen one. Bladen Aiden. What the heck is this? Oh, look at this picture. God, that's gross. Bladen Aiden. Ew. That's nightmare fuel right there. Like, you really want to scare a blader? Give him some ayahuasca. Let him stew for 30 minutes and then show him this picture. That's creepy. These cards were great though. I love it. I dig it. It's creepy in all the fun ways. But it's gross and I love it. We had cards for everything in the 90s. That ain't wrong. Message Lino. That's next. Yeah, that's next. I was trying to do it officially, but yeah, I'll message Lino. I only got a chance to talk to him very briefly at Winter Clash. I was trying to get my in, you know, trying to be like, yo, I'm Spook Wackadoo. Goes without saying, I love what you do. Let me know if you ever want to work on something together. He seems just like a blast to hang out with, and he got so much skate knowledge, you know. He's one of those dudes like Sean or Tree that you could, and or Clark, you could just sit around and talk blading about, and it'll be like, yeah, no, that, this is when that happened, this is how that happened, this is who did what, this is how that affected that, and it's so fun. It's ironic because I'm not a history nerd. I love history, but like, I'm not compelled to go out and learn about like political history, but things like blading history, art history, stuff like that, I love. You know, you feel me? You dig? All right, let's end with a Moon Man song. We'll go with Japan from the Vacation album. Yeah, all right, okay. Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I gotta stop procrastinating. It's time to get out, do some working out on them blades. It is 1 o'clock here, so I appreciate y'all coming through for this impromptu stream. I was saying earlier, my job is making it hard to have a scheduled stream just because we don't have a set schedule. It doesn't sound like, unfortunately, I'm gonna be getting that. So for the next little while I'm working this position, The streams are probably going to be pretty sporadic, so keep an eye on my Instagram for the interviews. We're hoping to have Mr. iRollerBoot on here soon. We all know lots about Ben, but there's still a lot that we don't know about Ben that, personally, I've been able to get to know him through the many times I've hung out with him. We all know he's an incredible guy, but he is interesting on so many levels, and it really is, that's going to be a really fun interview, so stay tuned for that. We're trying to get that one scheduled between him being in Barcelona and then me having a sporadic schedule and Meta being a father of two youngins. It's a lot to work with, but we're going to make it happen for y'all because it's a ton of fun to do it. Thank you, everybody that's been participating in the Religion streams. Appreciate you so much. Never hesitate to suggest someone that you'd want to have on. And hey, we've actually been asked just the other day. I won't reveal who yet, but we were just asked by a few people to come on. So we're gaining some traction, y'all, and that's all thanks to you, PBS viewer. Thank you so much for sharing and for being a big part of this community. Y'all mean a lot to me. So yeah, I'm gonna get going. I was gonna start rapping. Nah, I can't freestyle. Hold up. Let's see. I'll bring up a song. I'll embarrass myself. Well, see, I don't know. This will probably get me copyright struck because I'm pretty sure this is a Spotify thing, but let's listen to some Mac, yo. All right. Oh, yeah, Sean's going to be on too. Yeah, we've been scheduling a lot. Sean's on the list. We've got a list rolling. But yeah, Sean, look out for that invite at some point. Cause that's what'll keep me alive. Something that's easy in my mind. Please do not fuck up my day. Everybody want a headline. They don't got nothing to say. Except I'm coming back with the freshness. You know I love making the entrance. Nah, now don't get defensive. Time is a matter of seconds. One, two, yeah. Off to see the wizard lead the picture. Me and liquor, evil mixture. Demons clear to clean the whiskers. He be Mr. Fisherman. Back on my shit again. Doing my own dance. Feel the rhythm, that's no hands. I play your vision like programs. Busy living on triple digits. Young old man, y'all dead wrong. I'm up for with the echelon. So butter when the bread long. I'm gone, gone to my head. Gone to my head. Yeah. Floating back upon the scene. I'm saying hello. Doing my thing, I'm pulling strings like Tom Morello. I keep it moving, you'll be doing way too much. I ain't telling time, just tell you when it's up.
Yep.
Yeah. I'm only keeping good company. I am not talking to you if you don't have love for me.
Yeah.
One for you and one for me. I am not talking to you if you don't have love for me.
Love for me.
Do not touch that dial, I waited a while, been around just like word of mouth, you gon' hear me out, and I put that on my house, I'm always going overboard, I better swim before I drown. I'm like rubber with the bounce, 100 be the count, drumming loud as thunder with the sounds. I was young to fuck around, every summer wild. Always had it jumping at the house. Clapping for y'all, I'm into having it all. Feeling like Shaq with the car, stature is tall. Rolling around with my homies, a battery pack with my dogs. Fuck with my thoughts, having enough in a lot. Putting the check in the pot. Oh, I messed it up.
It don't matter, never mind the pattern when you
taking the shot. Sorry, Sean, I'm trying to read at the same time. I shouldn't be doing that.
Enough with the extras, fuck up my money, I swear I've been through it.
Yeah, dude, for sure. No, I'll... Meta and I are already on the same page. We'll get you on, brother. We're just trying to schedule.
I'm only keeping good company.
Hey, I like to hear that, Sean. I appreciate you. All right. I was just vibing. We out. Appreciate y'all. Thanks for coming through. Have a good day. Hope you get to skate. Later, bladers. Who do we appreciate? You know you gotta stand, goddamn, put your hands together. Everybody got the money, get the band together. Moving like you can't stand the weather, but it ain't gonna rain always. Sorry, Grindo. I'm sorry, homie. Appreciate you coming through. Streams are random now because I've got a new job. So, ring that bell. Come on through next time you can. Appreciate you. Take care, y'all. Later, bladers.